Oladimeji Ramon, the Nigerian Bar Association, between April 24 and 27, 2018, held its fifth Criminal Justice Reforms Conference in Asaba, the Delta State capital. The conference had the theme, Criminal Justice Reforms in Nigeria, the Journey So Far. It was a hub for cross-fertilization of ideas among critical stakeholders in the nation's criminal justice system, lawyers, judges, law enforcement agencies, such as the police, the Economic and Financial Crimes Commission, the Independent Corrupt Practices and Other Related Offenses Commission, the National Agency for the Prohibition of Trafficking in Persons, as well as Nigeria's electoral umpire, the Independent National Electoral Commission. They each took stock of their successes in the fight against crimes as well as the limitations confronting them in their different spheres of operation. Justice system near collapse in the Northeast, Mahmoud, the NBA president, Mr. Abubakar Mahmoud San, in his welcome address, said the conference became important at a time when the country was contending with an upsurge in the rate of criminality, which, according to him, had continued to put the justice system under pressure. Our country still labors under an effective administration of justice. Recent events and developments across the country are further putting undue stress on the system. In the northeast of Nigeria, the justice system is, for the most part, near collapse. In many other parts, there is steep decline to near anarchy. In Zamfara State, for instance, the killings and absence of law and order have become worrisome. In many states across the North Central, Benue, Taraba, Plateau, Kogi, the strife and killings have put a huge stress on the justice sector. In other states in many parts of the country, including the Southeast, the Delta region, kidnappings, robberies and various forms of criminality are becoming more and more common occurrence. All these underscore the continuing urgency for reforms for a more effective administration of criminal justice, Mahmoud said. The NBA president said part of the association's efforts towards criminal justice system reform in the country was its campaign for the domestication of the Administration of Criminal Justice Act 2015 at the state level. Mahmoud, who described the ACJA as a revolutionary legislation, said about 14 states had so far passed their versions of it, while others were in the process. To facilitate this campaign, the NBA president disclosed that the association in 2017 secured $1.8 million grant from the John D. and Catherine T. MacArthur Foundation for a three-year advocacy project on justice reform in the country. Under this project, we seek to leverage on our membership base of over 120,000 lawyers in our 125 branches across Nigeria to engender widespread criminal justice reform by encouraging the domestication of the ACJA 2015 in the outstanding states to ensure uniformity in the administration of legislation across Nigeria, Mahmoud said. EFCC, ICPC demand attitudinal change from lawyers for the acting chairman of the EFCC, Mr. Ibrahim Magu, and his counterpart with the ICPC, Drive. Musa Abubakar, there is a common concern, the snail's pace of criminal trials in the court. Magu and Abubakar are worried about the unduly lengthy court processes which have made it extremely difficult for their agencies to achieve closure in most of the criminal cases they have instituted in the courts. Presenting a paper titled, Corruption, Economic and Financial Crimes, Special Courts to the Rescue, the ICPC helmsman, Abubakar, said it was obvious that the regular courts, being extremely overburdened, cannot answer to the country's need for expeditious determination of corruption cases. He argued that there was only one way out of the logjam, creation of special court, with, of course, attitudinal change among lawyers. Abubakar said the creation of special court would be an eventual obedience to the provision of Section 61(3) of the ICPC Act 2000, which requires that the chief judges of states should designate a court specifically to deal with corruption cases and other related matters. He observed that though the Administration of Criminal Justice Act was passed in 2015 with specific provisions to check delay in criminal cases, the problem remains largely unresolved, mainly due to the continued manipulation of the justice system by the lawyers. According to him, a ready example is the case of the former spokesman for the People's Democratic Party, Olusegun Emeka, who is facing trial for an alleged fraud event 400 meters before the Federal High Court in Abuja. Now that the ACJA is in its fourth year, the question is whether all the clogs in the wheel of the criminal justice system, as identified by the Vice President, Professor Yemi Osinbajo San, Attorney General of Lagos State as he then was, have been eliminated? My answer to this poser from the perspective of prosecution of corruption and financial crimes is that the journey so far is not too good. The drama in the case of Olusegun Emeka is instructive here. It is worthy of note that the prosecution has closed its case since October 2016. Interlocutory appeals remain in vogue through employment of technicalities by defense lawyers, Abubakar said. He said though the ICPC believes that special courts are desirable to fast-track trial of corruption cases, there would hardly be any difference if the defense lawyers maintain their usual tactics of frustrating the smooth administration of justice. He, therefore, urged lawyers to be in the vanguard of the anti-corruption fight and put the society's interest ahead of their clients. You must avoid glorifying corruption, but insist on ensuring that justice is done. We should strive to leave a good and lasting legacy for the coming generation. This will require attitudinal change by strictly adhering to the relevant provisions of the Rules of Professional Conduct for legal practitioners, notably Rules 14, 30 and 37, most especially Rule 30, he told them. Speaking on the same theme as Abubakar, the EFCC acting chairman, Magu, said the socio-economic implications of corruption on the country were too grave. He recalled that an audit firm, PricewaterhouseCoopers, conducted a research in 2016, which suggested that Nigeria might be losing up to 37% of its gross domestic product to corruption by 2030 if the menace was not immediately checked. Corruption hinders economic growth and it is a severe obstacle to achieving the country's development goals. It diverts vital public funding needed for schools, roads and hospitals. It weakens the democratic process and undermines trust in national institutions, Magu said. He, however, said in spite of corruption's grave implications for the country, prosecuting offenders remains difficult, owing largely to delays stemming from lawyers' antics. Undue delay in the judicial process has become an albatross of the entire criminal justice system in Nigeria. It is extremely challenging in Nigeria today to prosecute defendants, particularly in corruption, economic and financial crimes. Some defense counsel pride themselves in their ability to stall prosecution of cases by endless, and sometimes frivolous interlocutory applications and appeals, blackmailing and intimidating judges who do not yield to their gimmicks with groundless petitions, and encouraging their defendant clients to malign the judges. To those lawyers, what makes a good lawyer is his ability to use every means available to prevent or frustrate the trial, weary the anti-corruption agencies and their witnesses so that the case would not be determined on its merit but on technicality, Magu lamented. Like Abubakar, Magu concluded that as desirable as the creation of special court was, mistakes should not be made to see it as a silver bullet that will automatically handle the issue of corruption, economic and financial crimes in the nation. We must, as a people, change our attitude to corruption. Lawyers, as social engineers, have a pivotal role to play in the battle, Magu said. Lack of financial autonomy for state judiciaries still a problem, CJN. The Chief Justice of Nigeria, Justice Walter Onogun, in his goodwill message bemoaned the lack of financial autonomy for the judiciary at the state level. According to him, this remains a huge obstacle in the quest for an efficient criminal justice system. Onogun called for appropriate constitutional amendment that will give full financial autonomy to the judiciary at the state level, expressing confidence that this will give a big leap to the administration of criminal justice system in the country. It is true that the judiciary at the federal level enjoys full financial independence. Unfortunately, however, the same cannot be said of the state judiciaries. The funding of the judiciary is crucial and it is the most important index for assessing its independence. The issue of inadequate funding at the state level is one of the greatest challenges confronting the judiciary of this nation. It is imperative that the applicable provisions of the 1999 Constitution be duly amended to solve the problem of state judiciaries. Perhaps a final solution may be found if it is provided in the proposed constitutional amendments that funds due to the state judiciaries be deducted from source when the states receive their monthly allocations from the Federation account and be paid directly to the state judiciaries. This bold step, if implemented, will go a long way in enhancing the administration of criminal justice in Nigeria, Justice Onogun said. The CJN said he personally appreciated the federal government's crusade against corruption as well as government's effort to promote transparency and good governance. He said though the judiciary had in recent times embarked on many initiatives to tackle the nagging problem of delayed justice, it would not rest on its laurels. INEC makes case for autonomy, National Electoral Offenses Commission in his paper titled Prosecution and Punishment of Electoral Offenses in Nigeria, the chairman of INEC, Professor Mahmoud Yakubu, submitted that absence of financial and administrative independence for the commission was limiting its efforts to prosecute electoral offenders. According to Yakubu, this limitation will continue as long as INEC continues to depend solely on the executive arm of government for its budgetary allocations. In many parts of the democratic world, including Nigeria, the electoral management body is saddled with the additional duty of prosecuting election offenses. This means that the electoral umpire must be truly independent in both financial and administrative capacity in order to effectively and efficiently execute the functions. This is surely not applicable to Nigeria, where INEC is still much dependent on the executive arm of government for its budgetary allocations. In order to effectively investigate and prosecute electoral offenses, there is the need for capacity building, adequate funding and manpower. These are presently challenges being faced by INEC, Yakubu said. He also identified the lack of statutory powers for INEC to arrest electoral offenders and investigate violations as a serious impediment to successful prosecution of electoral offenders. Yakubu said the way out was the establishment of the National Electoral Offenses Commission, which would relieve INEC of the prosecution of the electoral offenders, to allow the commission concentrate on the conduct of credible elections. He expressed the belief that establishing the National Electoral Offenses Commission would go a long way in reducing the spate of brazen impunity with which electoral offenses are committed in this country. He urged the National Assembly to pass into law the recommendations of the Ken Nomani Electoral Reform Committee, which had been reduced into a bill for an act to establish the National Electoral Offenses Commission and for matters connected therewith 2017. It is envisaged that the bill, when eventually passed into law, will ensure speedy and effective prosecution of electoral offenders and strengthen our electoral process, particularly the conduct of peaceful, credible, transparent, free and fair elections consistent with international standards and best practices. Yakubu said. Copyright Punch. All rights reserved. This material, and other digital content on this website, may not be reproduced, published, broadcast, rewritten or redistributed in whole or in part without prior express written permission from Punch. Contact via email protected, visited 167 times, 8 visits today.